Good morning, everybody. I am flying solo this morning. Emma has gone off to do some of her counselling work. So I'm in charge of getting the sheep out, getting them settled, defrosting everything, and checking in to make sure they're all okay. Fancy coming with me? Let's check on Hope and Pearl. Good morning, girls. Good morning. Would you like to come out? Hi. Hi. Have you been rolling in the hay? You're absolutely covered in it. Let me clean you off a little bit. Come here. You're just covered. Hello. Hope. Hope, do you want to come for a cuddle? And Farrell's come to say hello. Hello, Farrell. Good morning, ladies. How are we today? It's an incredibly cold day. Incredibly cold. Hello, Autumn. Hello, Maggie. Should I get you some food? You're hungry? Or we can say hello to Tweed. Boing, 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 boing.
I want you to go bouncing. Boing, boing, boing. Boing, boing, boing. Boing, 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 boing. Boing, boing, boing. Hop, 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 hop. You ready? We're going to hop together. Ready? Ready?
Hop. Is she having a moment?
You're so funny! Do you
want to
go back to Emma?
Autumn! Autumn! Biscuit! What a letdown!
So, thoughts on a postcard, guys. Apparently, these look like sheep faces, according to Pippa. What do you reckon?
So, evening stables. Or evening stables, evening yard. Got a bit of bling going on. What do you reckon, girlies? Time to get you to bed. Dinner time. Yeah. Having a drink. Watching the tractors come home for the day, because these guys are going to be going off gritting very shortly. It is time for dinner and these guys are waiting patiently. Oh, where's the other one gone? Oh, the other one is just staring at the hay, as you do. Dinner time in there. Christmas, oh, look at that steam. Christmas themed stable. We're getting some Christmas lights tomorrow. Farrell and Tinkerbell having some dinner as well in their little Christmas area.
So I have now started this video four times trying to say you talk headquarters. Who just thought it would be so hard? So I am ending the day. Autumn is getting in on the act, aren't you? As I think you're all realizing, she likes to be star of the show and she absolutely does not want to be left out. So yes, as you can see, it's been a bit of a full-on one. Every day's a full-on one, to be fair. Pip had the morning shift. I was, well, you may or may not know, I'm trained to be a counsellor. So I'm currently in my third year. I don't qualify until next November. So Pip is a superstar and she is, you know, she helps us with the children at home, as well as doing this with me. So together, we as a team make you talk. And yeah, so yeah, it's a bit of a juggling act, to say the least. You know, not only trying to work and study and set up a new business, charity, social enterprise, I'm not overly sure exactly what the right term is. It's proving to be a bit of a headache. We just can't work out the best way to get things up and running. We've been confused by so much different advice and conflicting advice, and we really don't know what to do for the best. But we've got a meeting with somebody tomorrow who is going to... That's the goats putting my dog in its place. We've got a meeting with a guy tomorrow who is hopefully going to give us a little bit of an idea of the best way to structure our company so we can just get up and going and registered. We applied for our license today officially. Well, made the payment for our license, didn't we? So that's exciting. So hopefully we'll get in contact by someone soon and we can get our inspection sorted. And we are also going to be sorting out our insurance, but we can't really do that properly until we actually have our company up and running, or our charity up and running, sorry. I say company because CIC is a community interest company, and then there's a social enterprise, and then there's charitable status, and then there is being a social enterprise with a charitable arm, which is what someone referred to me today. And yeah, so I don't really know what to call it exactly. But the bottom line is, you know, as all of you who are following us know, you know, our aim is to be able to work within charities and to be able to offer a companionship service for those that need it the most and access in the areas where it's most needed, and trying to support the mental health crisis, which basically is taking over. And I think it's safe to say you can all see how wonderful our animals are, and also see how much both myself and Pip absolutely adore them. They are such fun, and they love nothing more than just to be sat with and stroked and fussed with. They love nothing more than a pamper, and they are the biggest time wasters ever. It makes it very difficult to actually get anything else done. She loves nothing more than a neck scratch. So yeah, it's keeping us on our toes, that is for sure. But as it stands, we are completely self-funded because we've not been able to get up and running. So it's that in itself is a bit of a challenge, because obviously we don't want to start this venture with huge quantities of debt as well, because we want to be able to use every penny that we get to kind of get this moving forward and get this up and running. So, I mean, it's a shameless plug and something that doesn't feel comfortable to either of us to have to say, but we do have a PayPal page if anybody would like to kind of support our kind of costings and getting up and running and getting everything that we need to be able to get on the road and offer this mobile service. And I think Pip is in the process of kind of sorting out an Amazon page so that like an Amazon wish list type thing. So if, you know, if it feels more comfortable to you to actually get something in the particular, there will be that option as well. Because, I mean, quite frankly, these guys are eating us out of house and home with just hobnobs alone. It would seem that that is absolutely a favourite of the girls, as well as a ginger nut biscuit. So we're writing our risk assessments for the council. We have included in there, as part of our escape procedure, how do you think we could catch an animal that's escaping? And quite frankly, wave a bucket of food and wave a hobnob in their face and they'll come running. And we have actually put that in there. So we shall see if there's any feedback from that. The Cotswolds are a bit debatable at the moment, but they're getting there and they're getting so much better. But I need to go home really and see my children and say hello to everybody, and I think I could actually probably sleep out here with these guys. But anyway, I need to go get them to bed and go home and go and deal with the chaos that's there and go and see Pip. And yeah, tomorrow is another day and we will start all over again. So anyway, lots of love from UTalk HQ and from Maggie and from Autumn, who's been very nosy looking at the gritting vehicles. Anyway, I'm going. Lovely to see you. Well, actually, I haven't even seen you. I'm going. It's been a long day. Bye-bye.